buzzard.
The home of the buzzard.
The buzzard. This is 100.7 WMMS.
Cleveland. We've left our families to help you ignore yours.
Family time's always best when it's forced.
The Alan Cox Show.
On 100.7 WMMS.
Video software now. We do still need the assistance of our valued video experts back there. Parts unknown. Text to Alan. So glad to hear that Bill has got himself a new meal plan. I was worried he was going to be relegating himself to box lunches on the pool table. You see what he did there?
I get it.
Because he was talking about because
of a thing.
The thing about it is that you can't. Okay. Guardians baseball tonight. Early games, 6:10 tonight and tomorrow. So we'll roll out a couple minutes early. They're playing the Cincinnati Reds right here at home. Do they call that anything? Do they call it like the Ohio Classic or the Crosstown? What is it?
I thought it was like the Ohio Cup or something.
The Ohio Cup. The Reds are, well, they're above 500. Yankees got knocked out of the postseason. I don't know what the Reds' future looks like. They've got one of the best players in baseball right now. Joey Votto is going away, but this Ellie De La Cruz.
He's great.
Is bananas. So making Reds fans happy to be Reds fans, which isn't always the case. But they are in town tonight to play your Cleveland Guardians. It's the second to last series in this regular season. Two games here at home, and then they will finish the 2023 run at Comerica Park against the Tigers Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. And then that'll be it. They'll call it a season, and Terry Francona will call it a career. By most accounts, I haven't heard anything different about that. But that'll be tonight. We'll get you right into the first pitch, 6:10 tonight on MMS. Last couple of days for you to use the promo code SPICY at CLE Clothing Company. That will get you 20% off whatever it is that you want. If we were selling Travis Kelce jerseys, you'd be able to get 20% off of those. I was just listening to the little sports update there. And they were talking about how his jerseys have seen a 400% spike in sales because of Taylor Swift. I'm with you, Poundcake. Big, deep sigh. But listen, that is the power of Taylor Swift. Who cares why they're selling him? He's number 87 there for the Kansas City Chiefs. And the jersey now is being sold probably to Swifties, who will then summarily burn them when she breaks up with him.
Taylor Swift. Taylor Swift does not care about black women. She took their white king, and now they're
going to... Oh, is that who he is?
That he was. Now he's just...
What, he dates black girls?
He did. He made it very known that he loves the dark meat. Oh, he loves...
Well, no, didn't he just date...
Black queen.
He had his dating show, and didn't he just date the winner?
I think it goes back further than that. But he was a lot of black women's, you know... a hall pass for a white dude because he was like John B. He had like the mustache and the beard lined up. He looked like he definitely a white guy, but a white guy that hung out with like the blacks.
He looked down. It was yeah, like, but I mean he looks like 1,000 other guys. Like from
but he's
I mean
not 1,000 other guys.
I know he's a good looking dude, but
he's famous and he's rich. He's talented and he was down with the swirl, and we don't see that a lot of mainstream guys like. You know, very popular men who date black women.
Wow.
And then now, not only do you go from a black woman to a white woman, but Taylor Swift.
The whitest of white women.
My friend Plank.
No curves, no nothing. Taylor Swift.
Pumpkin spice latte come to life.
My cardigan, Taylor Swift.
Yeah, but also, this all feels very set up.
It is.
I don't think so. I mean, you're not going to take two people and force them to hang out.
Yes, you will. For the exact reason
neither,
you said.
Neither of them. Neither of them need money or
that's
clout or fame. Yes, that's always the point. It's either money or clout or fame.
You need more money and more clout, and she's going to probably push a new album. He's probably...
But she doesn't need his help to do that. She just came off a tour.
She's not going to not date hot dudes. Like, and who's hotter than
the MVP? I think she should.
She
I think
should
that's
date
the only
Pete
way
Davidson.
She's going to find true love is she's got to stop dating hot dudes And you want a Cleveland guy, date me, Taylor.
Yeah,
she should settle down.
She should date Pete Davidson.
She's going to date the alpha of the alpha, and no one is more alpha than the quarterback, the MVP that won the Super Bowl. Like,
but he's not a quarterback.
He's a tight end.
I bet he is. But no, the MVP.
He wasn't the MVP.
He wasn't the MVP. He's not the quarterback.
Okay, well, then even more reason for her to spite. He's not all those things.
Okay, wait. So wait. No, she's supposed to date the quarterback, but now that it's not.
She just wanted to spite everyone else and date.
So there's no part of you that goes, hey, these two people are getting to know each other, and they might really like each other's company. Nothing.
And I don't care if they do.
You have an utterly nihilistic view of these two, right?
Yes.
Listen, the one thing we can all agree on is when they do eventually break up, the songs are going to be, say fire?
All right, let's not step on Perez Bilton here. Because
the songs are going to be great.
Yeah, because Perez Bilton's got some info on that.
On the songs?
Mm-hmm.
Has she already written some?
Yeah, I mean, she's a business. She knows what she's doing.
Running back to you? Is that one of them?
No.
No. Oh.
You'll find out later.
Touchdown there?
Is that one of them? That's pretty good.
Rushed into my heart.
Over time, I'll forget you. All right.
This ain't no passing play.
Well, I can't wait for Perez Bilton then. Because what?
Tie up loose ends? Because he's a tight end?
No, bud.
No.
That's not it.
Tie up loose ends.
That would be the name of one of her songs.
Because he's a tight end?
Yeah.
Yeah, by the time he gets done.
Because it has the word end in it?
Yep.
Ah. Not I miss your tight end or something along those lines. That's a little on the nose, but okay. Well, anyway, anybody associated with this now, because they are in the white hot spotlight of Taylor Swift.
Emphasis on white.
Oh, yeah. The whitest of white and the hottest of the hots. There are indigenous activists now, Native American activists there in Missouri and Kansas, who are hoping that Taylor Swift might use her platform to get people to stop doing the tomahawk chop. This has been the bane of a lot of people's existence. You know, these professional sports teams like the Cleveland Indians, like the Washington Redskins, you know. There are still people who can't figure out why some of these professional teams have escaped that scrutiny. You've still got the Kansas City Chiefs. You've still got the Chicago Blackhawks, although that's named after a person. And so there, you've heard that chant at those Chiefs games. They go, oh, and they're doing this tomahawk chop, and they have, like, they do this at, like, Braves games too in Atlanta. Too, yeah. Where they've got the headdress. I think a lot of people might have abandoned the headdress because it's so egregious. But I don't know. They're painting their faces red because those are team colors. They're it's at Arrowhead Stadium.
What does
the
headdress look like?
I mean, you've seen what Native American headdress looks costumes and things like that.
Yeah. Okay.
So this group of indigenous protesters are like, you know, it would be cool if Taylor Swift could try to get them to end the tomahawk chop during Kansas. Now, that's a lot to put on her. She's like, I'm just having dinner with this dude. How did I get to be? But that's what comes with, you know, with great power comes great responsibility. Learned that from Uncle Ben Parker, the guy on the rice. But the organization is called Not In Our Honor. This does not honor us as indigenous people. Let me just take the unpopular opinion here, and I'm not advocating for or against. Couldn't you make the case that the tomahawk chop is a sign of bravery?
Or couldn't you just pivot and say it's about the steak?
Kansas City, known for barbecue, the tomahawk chop. Listen,
you gotta chop a steak.
I guarantee there's a steakhouse in Kansas City with a tomahawk chop on the menu. But wouldn't it historically signify standing up against the invading white man? Couldn't you make a case for that? The tomahawk chop, taking on the pale invaders?
Also, this isn't something that they are advocating for in, like, the Chiefs aren't saying, let's do this. It's the fans. You're not going to get the fans to stop doing it.
Right.
That'd be like asking the Browns fans not to bark. Like, it's going to... it's going to happen.
A little different, but yeah. I mean, I'm just saying, I take your point.
But it's like you can't, the team can say, hey, we don't advocate for this anymore, but the people that go to the games are still going
the
to
The organizations
it.
Have to put yeah. out a public statement saying, we're not into this, but what are you going to do? Alan, my black friend calls Travis Kelce spicy white. All right. Well, there you go. Spicy. 20% off at CLE Clothing Company.
Hey.
What would spicy white mean? Because he dates black girls?
Down with the swirl. You add a little spice to your, like, people who like a little
spice. Like, is that
in their
a big
milk?
Thing? Like, I dated plenty of black girls. Nobody ever called me spicy.
I already told you.
It wasn't this era.
For a white guy to date.
But they weren't calling me anything.
They were behind your back.
Yeah. I mean, they call me daddy.
Yeah, they probably didn't like you. It takes a certain amount of swag to date a black woman. It just does.
Are you implying that I don't have swag?
Absolutely.
First of all, you don't need swag to date a black girl. You just date her. I didn't have swag. Nobody was telling me that I lacked swag.
And her parents liked you and her friends liked you and her family liked you?
I got along with everybody. I met her through a friend. So that person said, hey, this guy's pretty cool. You might like him. And she did.
How sweet.
Alan, that's why Poundcake is sports talker in Cleveland. Mm-hmm. Number one sports talker from Cleveland Scene Magazine. Tying up loose ends. Mm-hmm. Travis Kelce, MVP. Mm-hmm. Quarterback of the Kansas City Chiefs.
I thought it was he played for Kansas City Chiefs.
Alan, Arrowhead Stadium plays the chant.
Oh, they do? Huh?
Well, there you go.
Then I take it all back.
Yeah, again, I don't.
It's Missouri.
It's a wild, wild state. It's the show me state. Mm-hmm. And that means show me what kind of terrible arm movements and sounds you can make. I don't know. Also in Kansas City, boy, you usually hear about employees shrugging their shoulders and going the other way. We've seen videos of like masked bandits just taking over like a Walgreens in San Francisco when they just walk in and they have giant bags and they fill them with crap. And all the security guard is doing is filming them because they're like, I'm getting $12 an hour. I ain't getting shot or stabbed or whatever.
I feel that.
Also in Kansas City, and we've all worked retail. We've all had those jobs. And, I got in trouble 30 years ago because I chased a guy out into the street who was stealing from my Blockbuster video. I got in trouble with corporate.
Yeah, they don't want you to get shot.
They don't want to lawsuit. So it's not about your well-being.
Well, yeah.
Anyway, this guy went the other way. This was in Kansas City as well. A guy working at an O'Reilly Auto Parts strangled a shoplifter to death.
What?
Imagine, so this is a guy who, it sounds like he really wanted to strangle somebody. Maybe this guy was just having a bad day. Carl Kempainen. Is the guy's name, 39 years old.
He's going to be campaigning for his freedom.
Gah!
Hey!
You got it. So two guys go into the store and start to steal stuff. Fight breaks out between those guys and store employees outside the store. So they go outside, and one of the guys working there strangles one of the shoplifters. The other guy got like hit in the head or, whatever. He had a couple of minor injuries. But Carl got his hands around the other guy's neck and killed him.
You got a dose to mess around and find out.
Yeah, but O'Reilly's is going to be like, we didn't tell him this isn't part of our training.
But you're getting $15.50 an hour and you throw it all. I mean, yeah, I don't know, man.
Yeah, no, there's no company. Love y'all, but if someone breaking here, they taking the equipment, homie.
I mean, I'm right there with him.
Poundcake, somebody breaks in here, he's out the door.
Oh my God, don't take that over there, and don't take that over there, and don't take that over there.
Yeah.
What if they try to take your computer,
Hey, where's
Mary?
Cody? He's already...
My laptop?
Take it.
It's all in the cloud. This is worth any of that. If someone came in here robbing the place with a gun or whatever, or a knife, take it.
What if they don't have a gun? They're just taking stuff.
How big are they? Mm-hmm. They might have a gun.
Regular size.
Maybe they might have a gun. You don't know.
But they don't have a
gun. Yeah, you don't know for sure they don't have a gun.
I'm saying in this scenario, they don't have a gun.
I'm not a very good fighter, I don't think. Maybe I'd throw a punch.
She's a lover, not a fighter. Mary, how are you going to ask people to invest in your comedy albums, in your life's work, when you won't even fight to keep it safe. You'd run away and let them, you'd let them take your hard written, performed materials from your computer and not fight them? How can you ask?
Your girl has an external hard drive, Alan.
That's what I'm saying.
Come on now.
That wasn't a trick question.
Everything's backed up, baby. Ain't nothing on this computer that isn't in another location as well.
I throw it up on the cloud, too, just in case.
Take my computer. Take everything. Take
so
my phone,
this guy,
take my purse.
This guy runs out of his job at O'Reilly Auto Parts and strangles a shoplifter to death. Somebody recorded the guy. He was like pleading for his life. Oh, oh, oh.
So stupid. No, I'm gasping.
Okay, how dare you? How dare
Man's last gasp and Poundcake just laughing at him.
How?
You knew he'd laugh at this.
Dare you?
I thought you picked this story so Cody would laugh.
Speaking of people trying to break in, there's Woody right outside the window there.
He's drinking out of a quart container that you put soup in.
It's like a...
That is a quart container. That's a to-go cup.
I thought it was a venti macchiato or something. Yeah, he's
food.
Walking around drinking...
It is soup. Okay, it is soup. Yeah, I thought that was coffee.
Like he's drinking wedding soup.
It's soup weather. Getting ready for soup mode.
Soup weather. We can't hear you, Woody.
I really thought he had a coffee in a, like he's on the bear drinking out of.
Right. I've got to take a break here. If you want.